I'm Elie Setback reporting.
So Dana White says that Paulie Malignaggi was beat up really bad in sparring and that there's no fight with McGregor. But obviously, until we see the 12 rounds, why do you say that? Release the video then.
Yeah, you know, look, a 12-round fight, I don't know how many rounds they were going to sparring. I know we just seen little clips, but things are different in a 12-round fight. You know, of course, Paulie was out of shape. He had just come off getting stopped, so I'm sure he was just doing it either for a check or just to have his name in the headlines, you know. So, but I'm sure if Paulie and Conor were both about to sign a contract and train for a 12-round fight, I think Paulie would look much better than how he looked. I don't think he'd be getting knocked down all over the place. Of course, McGregor outsizes him, but I don't think it would look like that. And of course, you know, Paulie being a two-time champion knows how to relay his energy over 12 rounds better than Conor does. He only has one boxing fight.
Let me tell you what Dana White said. He was on a podcast, and this is what he says. Do you think people really want to see Conor versus Paulie Malignaggi? People want to see Conor fighting MMA. That's what they want to see. The Mayweather fight was one-off fucking crazy deal. This is where he belongs. This is the sport he's in. This is the sport he excels in, and this is where he's a world champion. Why did Paulie Malignaggi get up and walk out of camp after two sparring sessions? Because it was the right fucking thing to do. Because he was going to get hurt. Because Conor McGregor was beating the shit out of him. I saw it. He says, Paulie Malignaggi got up and left camp, and he should have fucking got up and left camp because Conor was going to fucking hurt him.
That's all facts. That's all facts. Like, you know what I'm saying?
Why? Hey, let me go on. One more quote. Because Conor was going to fucking hurt him badly. It's no disrespect to the guy. It's a fact. I was there. I watched the whole fucking sparring session. That guy needs to go home, and he needed to leave Las Vegas.
Damn. Dana was going in. Why he going like that?
I don't know, but he was.
But, I mean, all he was saying was facts. We want to see Conor in UFC. I mean, I don't want to see Conor versus Paulie. That's like...
I would see it, but...
What? I mean, you would watch it because you're a boxing fan.
What if Paulie beats the crap out of him in boxing?
That'd be even a second.
If it's so easy, do it.
Exactly. But it won't look like that. But like, okay. We want to see Conor.
Do you want to see Conor Mayweather too?
No.
Do you want to see Conor against Nate Diaz?
I guess, man. If that's the only options he got, Paulie, Floyd 2, and Diaz 3, then goddamn, retire. Then, you know, you already made hella money.
Go fight Nate Diaz, and Nate Diaz is going to beat him.
Yeah.
All right, there you have it. Sharif Coleman right here. FaceTheDrewPoint.com. Basic back reporting. Hold on.
Reporting. Turn up the volume and just sit back. You rocking with the best. Elie Setback. The wave of the future. We don't lose. Tell me what you're watching. ES News. He came a long way. All the way from Jerusalem. Heavy on the grind. Competition. He abusing them.